The best in precision rifle component innovation was something I thought was crazy. TACCOM HQ, the same outfit that does the Charlie Tarak in it, they make barrels. And the engineer, Mr. Baker, who's in charge of TACCOM HQ down there, the man behind the operation, who knows a lot about the engineering, put a lot of that stuff together, he was an engineer that specialized in harmonics. Now, in other forms of industry, harmonics are incredibly crucial to a system. For example, on a car engine, right? If you got a V8 and you got your harmonic dampener up on front of the crankcase and you don't get that thing balanced properly, that wear that's induced due to bad out-of-balance harmonics is going to create a lot of extra wear and tear on the system. A lot of wear and tear on any vibrating mechanical system is induced or exacerbated by harmonic reverberations, because instead of parts smoothly operating in concert with each other, you got stuff chattering together and you got stuff fighting itself. And that's where a huge amount of the wear occurs mechanically. And when you're talking about harmonics, I've been preaching about this for years. You guys remember way back in the Sniper 101 series, I did a couple videos talking about this topic. One was specifically called harmonics. We talk about the seminar a lot too. But if you look at a standard rifle barrel, there's only a certain amount of rigidity you can gain through adding weight before the barrel gets so darn heavy you can't carry the rifle. For example, if you have a rifle barrel that's like not even contoured, right? Like you don't contour it down, the sucker is undeployable. Not deplorable, but undeployable. It's just too massive. And so you get rigidity by increasing that outer diameter of the barrel. That's the primary means of doing it. However, the problem occurs that a monolithic piece of metal has the reverberations transferred through it very easily. Like a solid solid rifle barrel with just the hole through the middle. And those reverberations are going to go forward and backwards very easily because there's nothing there to interrupt that harmonic signature. So what they've invented down at TACCOM HQ is what they call structured barrels, which I was very curious to see when I walked in there. I had no idea they did that. And I'll show you, and some of you guys have seen maybe some of the teasers I put on there, but they basically have it's like engineered lumber. You know how like on the new modern homes, they have like the rafters or the floor joists, whatever you call them, the boards under the floor that hold the floor up. And they're like quite a bit wider, but there's way less wood in there. And you have all the little triangles looking at, it's engineered lumber is what they call it. Well, just by taking advantage of geometry and engineering, they can have a very rigid piece of lumber that if you have a board that was the same weight as that was not engineered, this other piece of the engineered lumber is like multiple times more rigid and solid and less apt to flex than the other one. And what they're finding with the structured barrels is that with the amount of weight that the barrels are, they're very, very massive on the outside. But there's a lot of material removed from the inside in kind of a very unique, very smartly done way to where the harmonic reverberations that do exist in the system can't reverberate evenly through it. So it interrupts the harmonics in such a way that cancels it out. And you take all the vibration out of a barrel. And so you have a super lightweight barrel that's a very large outer diameter that's engineered. There's holes drilled around the axis of the bore going this way. And then it's also machined on the outside. They thought of every detail, man. It's machined around the outside where you've got threads. And those threads are interrupted. So the threads will go, then they'll stop. Then it'll resume for a second, then it'll stop. And then they'll go again for a while and they'll stop. And that's the finish on the outside. The idea there is that even harmonics can transfer along the surface of a smooth surface very easily. They resonate all the way to one end and come back. If you have an interrupted thread pattern on the outside, you kill the harmonics coming through that avenue. And then plus, one of the interesting things about the structured barrel I saw too, and we're going to do this in the review I'm going to show, we're going to actually let them explain it, is that actually creates a positive and a negative pressure flow as the gun shoots. You create the flow of gas. When the bullet, from the blast and then the bullet going down in the vacuum, you're sucking and pushing air through those vents and the gun stays incredibly cool, which is very interesting. Like when you read, when you can burn, I think we're shooting a 375 Shy Tac or a 408, I don't remember when we do the video, we'll show you. But we're shooting some big magnums. A 300 normal magnum was one we shot. We had an AR-10 and a 260 Remington with a structured barrel in it. And you can run any kind of ammunition in the barrel. We had all different kinds of ammo, different brands, totally different weights. One of them was in a 260 Remington, the AR-10 was. And we're running like 120s, 130-somethings, and 140s. And we're shooting at the target. And I had two of my other guys with me, the training cadre guys, to verify that we weren't crazy, because I like to not just have a single test. I like to get more of a baseline. And so I had them shoot the rifle as well. And we're all putting all the same exact, all the different loads through the same hole. That's weird. That tells me that one of the reasons for shot deviation in between loads is not just a velocity difference, but it is that harmonic whiplash pattern, as the theory has always said. Now, until they have like super high speed photography, it's kind of hard to actually mathematically predict harmonic vibrations. But if you take their harmonic vibrations down to zero, what I found when we're looking at those barrels is that there's like nothing happening. It's totally dead. Like when you shoot a normal rifle, you don't notice, but there's a lot of chatter that happens in your cheek. And you'll feel it, the fatigue in your face after a certain amount of time if you shoot a lot of rifle rounds. This one's totally dead, so it pushes straight back. It's like shooting with a big integral suppressor on. It's hard to explain. It's just kind of a straight back push, a very clean push. There's no vibrations. And you can do a very simple test at 100 yards, just shooting groups. And all the different ammunition are shooting the same hole. So I thought that was interesting. That's something we're going to share with you in the very near future, is a structured barrel design. So in terms of innovation, actually at the King of 2 Mile that occurred over this last year, I believe that that's what they came up with too, was the same conclusion. And they won the innovation award at the King of 2 Mile. So they actually, I mean, dude, like check this out. We even had one of the rifles, I forget what kind of chassis was on it, but the buttstock was like, because they had just like put it on in a hurry, because we're like driving there earlier than they thought we were. And the buttstock was so loose, it was almost ready to fall off, and it was just like wiggling all over. Normally, for those of you who are experienced in this deal, if you shoot a rifle with a loose buttstock like that, you're not getting minute of angle. You're getting like this or this or this in terms of your group size very quickly, due to a loose buttstock. That's very common. You're going to get like a foot size group. We see it all the time in the classes. I've done it a million times growing up, since I was a little kid, with all different kinds of two-piece rifle stock designs, things like that. And so we were shooting. I was shooting with one rifle. I think it was the 300 normal. And I was grouping in it. I was hoping for a one whole group, right? And it was kind of like, yeah, man, three or four of them would go in the same hole, and there'd be a flyer like half a minute off to the side or something. And I was like, man, what the heck is with this flyer? I thought my marksmanship sucked. And eventually we found out that the buttstock was totally loose. And it was like so perplexing, because like the reason the buttstock being loose is so detrimental is because of the harmonic vibrations wiggling it different each time. So it's connecting with your shoulder in a different way. That as that recoil is transferring in your shoulder, that bullet's still being pushed. It's Newtonian physics. So as that bullet is still being propelled down the barrel, you still got recoil coming back in your shoulder, and how that interfaces in the recoil dynamics against how this is either leaning this way or this way can totally throw you off. And so that's why the heart, that's why that can be an issue when you have a loose stock. But with that, the gun was still one hole in it for the most part, and had a half inch or a half minute of angle, or maybe a 3/4 minute flyer once in a while with a totally loose buttstock. And when you tighten it up, it's all in the same hole. That's crazy. So they've killed the whole barrel whiplash issue. They've completely killed it. And I think the barrels are 8 times more rigid than a barrel of similar weight that's not structured. So that's my list for 2018 of neat stuff that we saw. And I thought that I would share that with you guys.